Okay, so now we'll be talking about the mode function. Okay, so to access the mode function or the mode menu, so you just press this button, the mode. Okay, then you will be prompted by, I believe this is 12 options. Okay, now 11, so 8 plus 3, 11. Okay, so I will just be tackling about the mode that will be used or much or will be concerned, especially in taking the RMA exam, and that mode is the computer. So computer function or the default function of the calculator or the default mode of the calculator. That will be option number one. Okay. So if, for example, if your mode is not in one, for example, for some reason you accidentally set the mode of your calculator in 8. Okay, we'll just have that one. For example, this is the display of your calculator now. It is in vector mode. So you just press mode, then select option 1, and it will be returned to its default mode for your calculator. So if you have time, or if you are an engineering student, especially an engineering student, and you are also having your own review, so I will be making a separate video on all of this mode, because all of this mode will be useful in taking the electrical engineering board exam. Okay, but now we'll be focusing about the mode that is useful for the RMA exam, and that is the computer or the default mode of your calculator. So we have the ratio, the distribution, the inequality. Those are the other modes. Okay, so we just select one. Okay, now we will go to inputs. Okay, how we are going to have our inputs. Okay, so input in this calculator is very easy. So you just press the these numbers here. So have 1, 2, 3, so just like any other calculator. If you want to correct or to delete the previous function or the previous number you have typed, so you can have this one, the del, so it will be deleted. If you want to for example this will be a number, then you want to replace this one with a 4, so you just use this one. This is the navigation button. You can press this one, go to the I believe that this will be the left side, then you just delete, then replace that with 4. Or you could use the insert function, but I am not fan of using the insert function, because sometimes instead of deleting the input or one of the inputs, you are now adding an input, so maybe that will cause confusion as you go on with the with your inputs. Okay, so if you want to clear everything on your input, so you just press that one, the AC, no? AC, so AC means all clear for me, so that is how I call that one, AC, all clear. Okay, then you have also the functions here, the four the four basic operation, the times, the divide, the plus, and the minus. If you have if you are inputting a decimal number, so you have there the decimal, then the equal sign, then the answer. For example, 9 divided by 6, that will be the answer by pressing the equal sign. If you want to recall this one instantaneously, so just press answer equals, and the answer will be given again. Okay, so it it will be useful, this button will be useful later on. Okay, now we will have the this one, the times 10 to the power of x. So for example, if I'm going to write a number, a scientific notation of 3 times 10 to the power of 7, okay? So some of you, for those of you who are good in math, so you will be, you can input that one as 3 followed by 7 zeros, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So I believe that will be 30 million. Okay, or you can just have the easy one. Okay, so you have 3, press this one, times 10 to the power of x, and your x here will be your 7, then 7, then you still have the same value or the same answer. Okay, now if for example your exponent here is negative, okay, exponent here is negative, okay, so you just put a negative sign here. So that is how easy it is to input scientific notations in this calculator. Okay, so we just clear that one out. Now we will go to the inputs. Or for example, you are going to input fractions. Okay, fractions. So there are mainly 2 types of fraction in this calculator: the mixed form and the other form. Okay, so when you say the other form, a fraction consisting only of a numerator and a denominator. So in this calculator, if you will say a mixed form, you will have this one, 1 and 1/2. So basically you have a whole number and a fraction. So if you are going to write that one on the display, so the display with no input, so that will be like this one, the whole number over this another whole number. So that will be the icon on the bottom of your calculator. If the other type of fraction in the calculator is the one which has a denominator and a numerator, so no whole number. So in mathematics, this one will be a proper fraction, but you could also have improper, for example 19 over 2, and still it will be a box all over a box. So that's why we only have 2 types of fraction in a calculator: the mixed form and the not mixed form. Okay, so how to input first the mixed form? Okay, so very easy. So you are going to look for these icons here. So I believe this will be the one, except that we have the white here. So the white on the box, meaning that will be the default place of your first input. So for example, if you are going to type, if you're going to input this one, okay, I believe we are not on the natural display, we have natural display. Okay, so if you're going to press this one, so your first input will be on the numerator. So that's why we have the white. Okay, so let's go first input a non-mixed fraction. For example, this one, 3/4, so you have 3, then you press this arrow down, 4. That's how you input this fraction. Then for example, you want to multiply this one by this fraction, so you just press 19 over 2, and you have an answer. Okay, now how about mixed form? So mixed form, very easy. So if you are going to look for this icon, So above, we have the mixed form. It is color brown. Therefore, this one is a second function of this button. So we just press shift, then this button. So your default first input is on the whole number part of the mixed fraction. So 1, then arrow up. I forgot. Not arrow up, but to the right. So arrow to the right. Then 1 over 2. And you have. So your answer will be converted into a fraction which has only a numerator and denominator. So if you want to change this one into a mixed form, so you go back to your setup, then to your fraction, this one. So 1, and you will have an output of a mixed number or a mixed fraction. Okay, now how about if you want to input exponents? So for example, this one, 8 squared, or 8 to the power of 99. Okay, so we just input that one. So our input function is this one. So this is the exponent functions or the exponent button. So this is x squared and the x raised to n or raised to any number. So for example, 8 squared. So just press 8 squared. So just press this x squared and that will be 64. If you are going to have 8 to the power of 99, so 8, press this one, 99. Then you have this one. Okay, so the maximum number of the largest number you can input to your calculator is 1 times 10 to the power of 99, or 10 to the power of 99. So power below the Google. So Google is a number followed by 100 zeros, or 1 times 10 raised to the power of 100, that is in Google. But in the calculator, you only have a number times 10 raised to the power of 99, or a number followed by 99 zeros. So for example, 9 times 10 to the power of 99, that will be this one. But if you are going to have 9 times 10 raised to the power of 100, and you will have a syntax error or a math error. Okay, so that is the limit of your calculator. So if you are going to have an exponent, for example, 8 raised to the power of 100, so you can have this one. But if you are going to have 1 times 10 raised to the power of 100, so you will have math error because you go beyond the limit of your calculator. Okay, so that will be the way in which you are going to input exponents. So the x squared function, above that one we have the second function, the shift function, x cubed. For example, you are going to input 8 cubed, so 8 raised to the power of 3, so automatic you can input that one easily. Now we will go to radicals. Okay, radicals. So radicals, square root, cube root, fourth root, nth root. Okay, so for the radical, so we have this button, this is for the square root. The second function of this one is the cube root. If we are going to have the nth root, so this will be the second function of this x to the n button. Okay, for example, square root of 9, so square root of 9. 3, we have cube root, so shift, cube root of 27. Then if you are going to have the fifth root, so fifth root, shift, this one, the second function, fifth, so you input the 5, and you input the number you want. So 100, 125. Okay, so that is how you input your radicals. So that is basically the way you can input your calculator. So each button has its own function, but I am only discussing the function in which, based on my experience, are very useful in taking the board exam. So in the next video, we'll be talking about the output, how to have your output. So how to set up so that your output will not be confusing to you, or so that the answer of your calculator will not be confusing to you. So we will try to make the calculator much user friendly than it is designed to be. Okay, so see you on the next video.